Hello everyone, and welcome back to part 4 of our Elden Ring challenge run. So, as promised, I'm going to go and do that. I'm calling it a hero's grave. I could be wrong. But first...
I thank you. So what can I do?
Let's grab Order's Blade. Now for this we need 13 intelligence and 13 faith. So that's going to be our current goal. Now I did do a little bit between 3 and 4. I went to 3 nomadic merchants, one there, one there, and one there to pick up some more smithing stones so that I could upgrade my swords.
Well, where have you been hiding? I took you, no matter, it's all lay out your arms then.
Get them both up to plus 2. Could upgrade the bow. Why? Leaves me with just over 5k. At the merchants, wrong button. I did also pick up a new shield, blue gold kite shield. Puts me in heavy load, unfortunately. So I'm probably not going to have that equipped for the moment, because I'd rather not be on heavy load. You've probably seen while I'm here, where are you? I started with 9,000 runes.
You appear to be doing well. Well then.
That is because I did some grinding. I'm not going to bother with that.
May the golden now, order shine through.
I like to grind in Caelid. I know how stupid that sounds, especially this early on. But I'll show you why. Now, I don't know if a lot of you will be able to do this. I'm managing it because I have the speed stance, two Uchis, both of which do bleed damage. But I'll show you the run I make that can net you an easy, I want to say between 6 and 9k. Wrong button. If you're careful. And I do stress, if you're careful. Because, especially this early, these guys hit you, they're going to one-shot you. He's spotted me. Now I've never been hit by that beast slash attack, so I don't know how much damage it does. That's not particularly the attack I'm worried about. But as you can see, took him down. I didn't get hit. Okay, he spotted me. But that's, it nets you an easy K in runes. And there's a few of them lying around here. You can generally sneak up on them if you get the timing right. That's automatically almost half his health gone. So by the time I get a combo on him, he's dead. Easy peasy. An easy 1,000. Oh, I can't see which direction he's facing. There we go. like I said, I know a lot of you are going to say you're an idiot, like you're way underleveled for that area. Yes, yes I am. Like I said, if these guys hit me, I'm dead. Instantly. Like, these guys will one-shot me. For starters, all of their weapons produce bleed damage. The guys with the... saw on a pole, I'm going to say, because I don't really know what that weapon's called, aren't too bad. Shit. It's these guys that are the problem. These guys throw that sickle at you, and it's an instant grab attack. It's an instant death. And that's not just now, like, that has killed me when I'm prepared for Kaven. But, as I said, if you're careful, watch what you're doing, play your sneak attacks. You can net an easy couple of grand. I went from 9, it's from 4 to 9. I've got myself an extra 5 grand already. There was a guy around here. This is where he sneaks up on me. As you can see, just to the left, I haven't picked up any items because you guys couldn't see it. And I've not got any of the other graces. I've tried not to really explore into any regions you've not seen me be in. I've just grabbed the 3 merchants and a bit of XP from this little patch of grass here. Oh no, I thought he was facing this direction. He wasn't. So there you go, hemorrhage. Nice and easy. Let's get ourselves another gold seed. Gold seed? Golden seed. Okay, so there's 2 here. As you can see, I've pulled one away. The other one hasn't aggroed. Hoping to keep it that way. Because if these guys gang up on me, I'm dead for sure. And of course, he's one of the guys with the chain inside. Ah, shit. So there you go. Half my... My hemorrhage bar went straight up and he pretty much almost killed me in one go with it. And I've done it again. It's because I keep pressing or clicking the L3 instead of holding the circle. So that's what, 9, 10,000? Okay. So let's mosey on down to here. An attempt to get a dragon seal. So I can finally start using some spells. Okay, let's up our flask charge, get ourselves another heal, and then got our vigor to 80, dragon 20. So we need intelligence 13 and faith 13 to use that spell. Unfortunately we can't get both, so we'll go with that. Our next mark will be faith up to 13, and then we'll start pumping mind and possibly endurance, because endurance is our stamina and our equipment load. And there's one of those chariots I was talking about before. Obviously, he moves a hell of a lot faster than I do. Wait for him to come back. And run like hell! Don't worry about this muppet. Drop straight down. Doesn't sound like the... I was about to say it doesn't sound like the chariot's following, but it is. And bugger. That was so close. You will probably get to a point where you can survive a hit from one of those things. I vaguely recall by the time I'd beat some of the later bosses in my normal playthrough, I was surviving one hit from this thing, but I was also fully decked in Radahn's armor. Now, I've just realised I made a mistake here. Because you want that thing to go back up. Like that. Now run. I think I've just made another mistake. Oh no! Normally that would come straight up here and that's it, you stay there. Damn it. Got lucky. Cool. Now this guy's a dick. He has dragon breath attacks and he has ash attacks. The ash attack is horrible. He will slam the ground creating a whirlwind and then leap at you. The dragon breath is just a dragon fire attack. It's not difficult to avoid. It's this that is. I might be biting off more than I can chew taking him on. Mind you, I've beaten bosses already, so. The knights are just really freaking aggressive. Maybe I should have bought that armor. Oh, hello. I think you can get that chariot to kill him, possibly, if you're clever. I've never tried. I'm not sure I'll risk it, to be honest. Maybe you can't get it to kill him. Ow, shit. That was cheap. Damn it. I wonder if my... Order Blade would help me against him. Mind you, if I go down that road, I've got to change my weapon as well. The Uchis can't be enchanted. But I could end up changing to a great...
Stop doing that!
Great sword instead, for the sake of that fight. You've spied me, you little bugger. Ow. Yeah, wait. Sure, I was going to say, I'm sure it's another one. Spotted me as well. Thank you. bollocks. See what I mean about you dying to these guys very quickly. Unfortunately, being out of stamina is a bitch. How much do I need? Faith is 8, so I need 5. Wow. I need a hell of a lot. About 20,000. Okay, guys, well, I will be right back when I've got what I need. Welcome back, guys. So, done my room farming. My faith up to 13. Now, of course, like a noob, I've not checked. Switch, no. I can't. What do I need to wield that? 16 strength. What do I have? Not 16. So, like a Muppet, I've put all my eggs in one basket and then gone, whoops. Can I get you without being heavy load? Yes. Can I swap? Yes or no? Now I'm heavy load. I'm back to medium load. Can I? I've got to memorize my spells. And then, yes I can. Okay, so doing that will allow me to use it effectively. And two-handing will also allow me to block. Ah! Shit. Now that's messed me up. See if this has any effect on this guy at all. I cocked up. But there we go. And I got my Dragon Communion's heal. So we got it, guys. That was not for nothing. That's going to do it for this one. We'll come back next time and we'll finish exploring this area. Hopefully back with our Uchis, because I want to stick with my speed stance. Until then, guys, take care.